Reggae Uprising with your host, Danieal.
Greetings, Reggae Uprising Podcast family, and welcome to another episode. If you are fresh and new to Reggae Uprising Podcast, it is all about connecting people of the African diaspora through wisdom, overstanding, inspirational stories, all backed by a soundtrack of sweet reggae music. So what usually happens with our episodes is each and every Wednesday, I feature a new guest who shares their heritage, their wisdom, their journey, their inspirations alongside seven reggae selections. And the purpose of this is to share wisdom and also be able to network with people and know what they're all about. So I encourage everybody that listens to the show to connect with my guests, as that is the purpose of this whole show. However, for my regular listeners, you know that I've been doing something a little bit different throughout the summer. So for June, we had a special series called the Exodus Edition. Now, big up everybody, all of my regular listeners, for all of your support, for subscribing, all of your beautiful comments, for sharing in your network. I really, really do appreciate it because it surpassed all expectations in popularity and response. Now, for you, those of you that haven't already heard it, that are new, we featured four African countries, including Uganda, Ghana, the Gambia, and Ethiopia. And the mission of the series was to uplift the wisdom from those who are living it to those who are dreaming of it. And in doing so, dispel myths and bring your vision into perfect clarity. Yeah, so the topics that we included were land prices, the cost of living, transport, that vital paperwork that you need to know about, obviously COVID restrictions, how they were at the start of COVID restrictions, how they are now, business ideas, do's and don'ts, and the most important, the most important were the first-hand experiences of each guest. Now, I think the reason for its success is the abundance of information shared by my insightful and inspirational guests, as well, we can't forget this, as well as the reggae artists' high vibrations hailing from the featured country. Yeah? So what I want to do before we get started with what's going on in July, what's going on for these episodes, is give thanks for all that shared their love, time, and wisdom in making this series and for you in receiving it. I really, really do. Thank you so much. Thank you. More love to each and every one of you. Right. Now, I know I've kind of kept you into sense. Oh, before I get into what we're doing right now, if you want to get caught up on any previous episodes, so if you've already checked out the Exodus edition and you want to check out those previous episodes, or if you're fresh and new, like I said, you can click the subscribe button on wherever you're listening to this episode. Alternatively, you can go to danieal.co.uk, where as well as getting all of these podcast episodes, you can also get my music, because I am also a reggae soul singer. So you can check out my previous music videos. You can find out when I'm putting on my next show. You can find out all of those high vibrations. You can find out the previous online shows that I did. So we have High Vibes Fridays. We have Reggae Uprising Selector. There's a whole load. If you like reggae, you come to the right spot, basically. There's a whole load of shows and reggae music for you. So yeah, you just go to danieal.co.uk. So that's danieal.co.uk. I'll repeat it again, danieal.co.uk, danieal.co.uk. Now, as for this month, as for July, This is going to be the self-healing series. So all throughout July is a self-healing series. Like I said earlier, throughout the summer, each month we're going to be focused on specific things that are really important, not only for this podcast, but for you, my listeners. And you let me know what you wanted me to focus on for these three summer months. So self-healing series is what July is all about. So this episode will serve as the introduction, where I'll be sharing the top five strategies for living your best life. And just to let you know, for the rest of July, my featured guests will be sharing their nuggets of wisdom and some very important knowledge as part of this special series. Now, the past 18 months have been a test of mental strength for everyone, no matter your individual situation. And we've all devised coping strategies, some helpful, some harmful, some conscious, and some unconscious. But one thing that is for sure is that connecting with one another is pivotal and vital to mental well-being. But to make the most of our moments together, how can we strive to uplift ourselves first, so as to reflect a positive vibration? This self-healing series' sole focus is to overstand and rise above. So I'm going to talk through five strategies to help keep you in check, keep perspective, and ensure honor, live it up. Yeah? Now, of course, we are going to go as we go through. I'm going to match up our five strategies with five reggae songs. Well, come on, it had to be done. This is Reggae Uprising Podcast. Yeah. So I want this episode to serve not only as just a one listen wonder. I want it to be something you come back to a second time, you know, and make some notes of things that you find most helpful for you and what really resonated with you, and implement them into your own well-being strategy. Yeah, because I want people to take, like I said, take what works for you, what inspires you, what resonates with you, and build with that. Right, so number one is daily rituals. So these are rituals of empowerment, rituals of inspiration that you implement daily. So, meditation. Now, everybody comes to meditation in different ways and uses different ways to kind of ease themselves into it. So don't have massive, massive expectations when you first try and get into meditation. Yeah, build slowly. All of these things that we're going to talk about today, you start small and build them up slowly. Yeah. So it might be that you start off with a couple of minutes, and then you build up to 5 minutes, and then you build up to 10 minutes. And don't put yourself under pressure. That is not the purpose of meditation. That is not the purpose. So some people like to do meditation in just pure silence. Some people like guided meditation, which I know there's multiple ways that you can access that online. Some people like meditation with some relaxing music. Some people like meditation with gongs. So it's just a case of trying out different ways until you find what suits you best. And also think about where it is that you're going to meditate. If a certain space doesn't work for you, try somewhere else. Just keep going with it until you find your fit, because it will fit. You just got to work out what works for you, and you are worth the time in figuring all of that out. Right, another daily ritual that I would add in is self-affirmation. So have a little think about three things that you need to know every single day. I want you to write them down. And I want you to memorize them, get them into your head. And then every day when you wake up, I want you, after you've done your meditation, obviously, I want you to go to the mirror, look yourselves in the eyes, right in the eye. Yeah. And you tell yourself those things. You tell themselves those things and mean it. And mean it. And make sure you do that every single day. And you will see the evolution of what that does in the mirror. That's all I'm going to say. That's all I'm going to say. You have to do it. Like I said, stick with these things. And the third thing I would say to have as your daily ritual, obviously you can add to these things. These are just, you know, the bare bones, is daily exercise. So whatever works for you in your routine of what you already do in however your life works. So you need to fit it in whatever works for you, like I said. So you might go for a walk. These are all things, like I said, is best done in the morning. So if you do your meditation, then you do your self-affirmation and then your exercise. So it might be just a small group of different exercises. Say you might start off with like 5 different exercises, and they might be something that you do in your house in the morning before you have to go to work. So that might be one example. Or you might have more time. So you've got time to actually do a whole, for example, yoga routine. Again, all of these things you can find online now on YouTube. Or you might have quite an abundance of time, so you can work through each of these rituals quite slowly and at your own pace, depending on your lifestyle. So you can spend a nice amount of time doing your meditation. You can add more affirmations, and then you could go for a walk. And while you're walking, you could think through the affirmations that you've picked and maybe add even more to them, because movement with affirmations makes the vibration of them even higher and even more powerful. They resonate even more with you when you add movement to affirmations. So if you can do that whilst you're doing your form of exercise, that will make them that bit more powerful. So number one in the strategy is definitely daily rituals, and make them your priority. Make them important to you. No days off. Because this is all about self-healing. This is all about you. And with that said, we're going to have our first selection, which is Bob Marley, Wake Up and Live.
Already used to live big today. casket. One cocoa for a basket. Yeah, yeah. Pretty easy, live big today, tomorrow you're buried in a casket. What?
Strategy number two is monthly goals. So in those goals, don't just put in things that are easy for you to achieve or things that you're quite confident in. Throw in a curveball. So throw in something new, something that is out of your comfort zone. Yeah, that's what, in fact, do that as your first one. Think of something that you're like, you've always wanted to do, but you're like, oh, and you just keep putting it off. That's the number one that you want to have as your monthly goal. And you'll find that the more you put those in, once you've achieved those things that maybe you were apprehensive about and you've achieved them, the next month you'll be excited about achieving that goal because it's a challenge now. It's not fear anymore. It's a challenge and it's something else to achieve. And it'll just make you feel really, really good. So much better than anything else on your list once you've achieved that. As well as doing the something new, maybe as well with your monthly goals, start off with a yearly list. So start off with what you want to achieve for the year and then break that down. So then things that might look really scary that you want to achieve for the year, once you've broken it down into months, it doesn't seem so overwhelming. It doesn't seem so overwhelming. And you can actually track your progress as well from month to month and make sure that you're actually on course to achieving your year goal. Again, when you're doing these monthly goals, if you don't achieve one of them by the end of the month, it's okay. The whole purpose of this isn't to put pressure under yourself. It's to recognize yourself. It's kind of like a self-analysis. So if you didn't achieve that goal, you can look at it and go, okay, why didn't I achieve that goal? What were the barriers that I had to overcome? And how did I get around the things that that stopped me? Or maybe I still have to work that out. But it's for self-analysis. It's not to beat yourself up with. It's not to be a negative thing if you don't achieve those goals. Or maybe the goals that you've put down as well, maybe they weren't Maybe they were kind of unattainable for that month. Maybe you were set, you realized, hold on, the goals that I set myself, I'm kind of setting myself up to not achieve them because they're just that ridiculous. And I'm just causing myself more stress by thinking that I can get all these things done in a month. But realistically, it's not actually possible for me to do all those things. So maybe I need to reevaluate how much stress I'm actually putting myself under by having these unrealistic goals. And like I said, you can self-analyze and go, okay, looking at this now, I can see why I'm stressed. I can see where I'm going wrong and I can readjust it rather than keep going in the same spiral and getting more and more and more and more stressed and then not really achieving anything because I can't sleep or I'm not being my full potential because, for example, of sleep deprivation, of stress, of anxiety and all the things that come with having unattainable goals and then the negativity that comes from that as well. So like I said, make sure those goals are actually achievable from writing these monthly goal lists. Make this a positive experience, not just a task list of, oh, I can't believe I've got all this stuff to do. And that's not the purpose of it. That is not the purpose of it. Like I said, it's all about self-analysis and realizing what is realistic, where you've gone right, the wrong turns that you've made, and how you can reestablish the best route forward. Yeah? So that is strategy number two. And song number two is, funnily enough, here we go, is Taurus Riley. No need to worry.
No, no, no. Crash. Enough of them can't sleep at night. Them I worry and fret. One bag of drinking, a bag of cigarette. But me, I fret. No, no, no. I no need to worry. A clean life and pure living straight. I no need to worry. No crosses and no follow me. Hey, no, no, no. I no need to worry. And my mommy, I pray for me every night. I no need to worry. When I listen, I no need to worry. So much I know. Me nah go follow none of the trends, them. I'll kill myself with the bends, them. Tell all I get to youths from the ends, them. Don't bother with the spent shells, them. If it empty, are you playful? You can't be ungrateful. Stand firm, be faithful. I look in the mirror, I say, I don't need to worry. A clean life and pure liberty, straight. I no need to worry. No crosses and now follow me. Hey, no, no, no. I no need to worry. Hey, mama, pray at them, I cover me. Every night, I no need to worry. When I listen to me, I don't need to worry. None at all. Well, every day, them get up and I murmur. It's like them want curse. Me know I say, me I know the worst. I've got so much things to give thanks for. Going forward, want me fi reverse for. Where you want me fi drive in a hearse for. Who Jah bless, no man curse. And I tell me I work for. I ain't no need fi worry. I clean life from pure living straight. I ain't no need fi worry. No, my family now go hungry. No, no, I ain't no need fi worry. Hey, my mommy, I pray for me. Yeah, yeah, I ain't no need to worry. What are they swimming? I ain't don't need to worry. I know, no. No, 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 no. No stress, no. Ah, the blessing them surround way. So again, you know, come on.
So all of these strategies all flow in and out from one another. And that's the reason that I've done this in the order that I've done them in. So the third strategy that I would say is self-evaluation. So when I say self-evaluation, I would say the probably the easiest and most obvious way to do that is to keep a journal, keep a diary. And be real with yourself in it. Be real about how you're feeling and, you know, what happened on that day, the interactions that you had with people, you know, what made you laugh, what made you smile, what made you sad, what made you cry. Be real with yourself. Be honest with yourself, because the more honest you are with yourself in that journal or in that diary is the more benefit that it will serve you in the future. It will serve your future self. So you can look back on that and maybe see, okay, why was I feeling? Can I kind of link back as to why I was feeling what I was feeling that day? Or if, say, I had an argument with somebody today and I kind of overreacted to them, can I look back in my journal, in my diary and say, okay, I can kind of see where that started from, and how that grew throughout the days and why that specific situation triggered me. Yeah, so that's what that can help with. It can also help with, again, what we said about the goals, about things that are stressful in your life. And maybe in doing the journal, you're journaling, and there might be a specific point that keeps coming up time and time again throughout your journal. And maybe that is either a problem to be solved in terms of you really need to take more time with that specific thing and sit with it and figure out exactly what it is that is so stressful. Or maybe it's something that you need to remove from your life, but only through journaling and only through doing a diary and being really honest will you be able to figure that out. Because you can ask other people's opinions on why they think, you know, you were a certain way at a certain time, but only you will know your truth. People will just have their perspective on your truth. Only you will know your actual truth. So yeah, you can, like I said, you can learn from your losses and your wins as well. Yeah. So it's almost like you can make your own, it'd be easier for you to make your own specific strategy and your own blueprint and your own algorithm, if you want to call it that, as to when you win and how you win and what are your real strengths and your real weaknesses, and be aware of them and work with them and try and empower yourself more by knowing them. Yeah, don't be scared of things that times when you've lost, because that just builds, that is the building blocks of your future. The times that you lose are the building blocks of when you will win, because you've had those experiences and you know how to deal with them now. Yeah. Also, try and acknowledge where your fears come from and be aware of them and more conscious of them so that you can be the master of them. If you can reevaluate yourself and find the sources of your fear, it will empower you immensely. So there are lots of different ways in which, you know, we're told that we're not good enough, we're not rich enough, we're not beautiful enough through social media, through the media in general. And the world is becoming so much more of a judgmental place in terms of that, in terms of shallow things that in reality of thing, in the grand scheme of things, really aren't that important. They're really not that important. And the more we grow, the more we'll realize that they're not important. But like I said, if you keep that diary in that journal, you can look back on how you thought about things and think, and when you're maybe not in that zone and go, wow, I can't believe I thought like that, or I can't believe that I let that wind me up or that get to me that much. That really wasn't worthy of my time and my energy. And that's not where I want to put my time and my energy. I want to put it into positive things. And me keep reliving the same cycle over and over again, I can see how unhealthy that is. And I can see where I need to invest some time and some energy and maneuver that into that positive thing that I want to do and that positive person that I want to be and that positive influence that I want to be to other people. So like I said, having a diary and a journal is priceless, is really, really priceless, because you can have a look at yourself. And the whole purpose of it is to see, you know, where you might be fighting yourself, where you might be fighting certain things, but you don't need to. You really, really don't need to. With that said, the next reggae selection is my original works. So it is Danieal. Don't fight yourself.
It's so simple, so uncomplicated. Being a follower, so overrated. So let's
choice, oh, oh, choose to love yourself inside. You know the time is now. Don't fight yourself, just let go. Your destiny, only you know. Don't fight yourself, just let go. Spirit, guide the way for you to go. Don't fight yourself, just let go. Your destiny.
Vibrations, you can check out the full music video for Don't Fight Yourself via danieal.co.uk. Now, strategy number four is self-love. So treat yourself, treat your mind, body and soul. Yeah, and let me just say something before we get into this, and it's in treating yourself. I don't know why when treating yourself, people like decide that that's, I'm going to eat the worst food possible. How is that treating yourself? How is that treating your body? It's just not. It's not. It shouldn't be called a treat. It should be called a trick. Yeah, because you harming your body is of no benefit to you. Yeah. So I was going to start with mind, but we'll start with body because I started talking about body. So rather than do something that's harmful to your body, how about detoxing your body rather than toxifying your body? Yeah. With these bad treats, so-called treats. How about you detox? Yeah. So there's plenty of different ways to detox. I am not going to advise you on any of them because it's not my place. But there's plenty of different ways for you to detoxify your body. Water being the main one, obviously. Plenty, plenty, plenty water, right? Apart from that, for your body, you know, you can just have a day where, yeah, you can have a whole day. I said it, a whole day where you, you know, have a beautiful, lovely bath with all those essential oils. You know, you have a massage. If you have a partner, this is where you utilize them. Have a nice, nice massage. Have a face mask. Treat yourself. Be good to yourself with things that are actually good for your body and that are going to do good to revitalize yourself. Just spend that day, you know, looking at different parts of your body, like being thankful for the different parts of you and being fully aware of self. Yeah. So we're going to move on to mind. Choose a book to help you with you. So if there's something in your life, like I said for earlier, from doing the journal, that you realize you're craving something specific in your life, whether it might be something to do with your history, whether it might be to do with self-care, self-love, you want to find out more about how do you detoxify your body? How can you eat healthier? How can you, if you have certain ailments, how can you find, what can you do to empower yourself by, you know, eating certain foods or taking certain herbs? What can you do to help yourself through knowledge? So that's how you treat yourself with your mind, with knowledge that is relevant to you, not by following what somebody else told you to read. No, what are you drawn to? What do you need to know more about? So that is how you treat your mind. So we're going to move on to treating yourself with your soul, being free. Now, however that works for you, whether that is music, like the music that we're playing today, music that uplifts you, treat yourself, immerse yourself just in music and just feel it and be completely, like I said, immersed in music. Don't have any other distractions. Whether you can, you're in a situation where you can pump out some tunes, or if you're not in that situation, you can put some headphones on, some noise cancelling headphones on, and just immerse yourself in the music and just be there and present. Yeah. You're also, another one is your creative self-expression. So however you do that, whether you might draw, you might paint, you might just dance to that music that you've been listening to, you might just want to dance, just whatever you do to set yourself free and just be you, to just be you and just be. It might be one of the first strategies that we said. It might be a meditation. That's how you connect. It might be going to a green space and just being, just sitting in silence, listening to nature. It might be that you are somebody that loves water and you go for a swim in the sea. It could be anything, whatever you have to do for you to connect your soul. It might be somebody that you actually have that deep, deep soul connection with. And it might just be a conversation, or it could be something as simple as a hug. Don't forget how important hugs are. Yeah. So you know what works for you, but make sure you make time for that self-love for your mind, your body and your soul. Each one is just as important. Now, our next selection is I Am That I Am. Peter Tosh.
I'm not in this world to live up to your expectations. Neither are you here to live up to mine. Yeah. I don't owe no one, no obligation. No, I don't mean none, so everything is fine. I said I am that I am. I am that I am. beauty. I said, I am that I am, I am, I am, I am. I am that I am, I am, I am, I am. I am that I am, I am, I am, I am. I am the rock of ages, you cannot move I at all. I am the son of lightning, you cannot move I at all. Son of Jacob, cannot be moved. I am the son of Moses, you can't move us. I am the son of David, you cannot move us. I am a firm like thunder, you cannot move us.
Final strategy, strategy number 5 is to give thanks. Now, this comes under the first strategy, actually, because it is a daily ritual, but this should be done multiple times throughout the day. Multiple times. So we should be giving thanks all throughout the day, whether it's something as simple as for the food and drink that we eat, the air that we breathe, whether it be our loved ones, opportunities that we come across, trials and tribulations, people that we meet. We should be thankful for all of it, for each single bit of it, because each single bit of it is a lesson that we were put here to learn. I know sometimes it might not feel like it. It just might feel like you're being persecuted, or, you know, there's a whole load of negative emotions that you can feel about certain situations. But if you try and keep that perspective that this is a lesson that you were put here to learn for a specific predestined reason, it makes it so much easier to learn that lesson. So look over the people and the opportunities that you are thankful for. Like I said, the achievements you've attained, the people you have loved. You could even, if you want to do something specific in terms of giving thanks, you could make a folder. So you could make a folder which is all about giving thanks. So you could put images in there. So there might be loved ones, certain memories that you hold at certain times in your life. And then you could also put a playlist in there. So you could put in certain songs that remind you to be thankful, that talk about all the things that you should be thankful for. Yeah. So you can actually, when you know that you might not be feeling that thankful, you might be feeling those negative emotions, you can go back to that folder and you can go, hold on, this is why. When I keep asking why, this right here, these people in these photos, these reasons in these songs that they're talking about, that is exactly why. And that's why I will continue and carry on. And that is why I will give thanks. And another reason to be thankful is for the massive, gargantuan reason. That word in itself isn't even big enough for what I'm about to say. But give thanks for those people that came before you and are the reason that you're even here. Everything that they went through to get you to this point that you are at, give thanks for that. That's why you should give thanks. Multiple times a day. So this is really important to be part of your strategy. and is the most powerful of all of them. I hope that this episode has empowered you, inspired you, and you're really feeling the high vibrations. Please, if you haven't already, subscribe, share the love, share these works in your network for the upliftment of all. And I will see you next Wednesday for another episode. I am going to leave you with the sounds of another one of my works, and it is called Bless My Soul. I hope you have a wonderful week. As always, blessed love. This is dedicated to, well, you know who you are. In you, it reigns supreme, spiritual day.